Hello! Procreate is coming out with a new update soon, and today I'm going to show you the new features that will be available in the Procreate 5.2 version. I'm testing the beta version of the update on my iPad Pro from 2020. With the update on iPad Pros with iOS 15 and with 6GB of RAM, you will be able to use the extra memory and have more layers and bigger resolutions. The canvas size can be up to 16,000 by 8,000 pixels, and there will be more layers for animations. The most promoted feature on the upcoming update is painting on 3D models. You will be able to paint on imported 3D models, and here as you can see, I have downloaded 3 models that I can now paint on. So let's try it out. I'm going to do glasses. You can rotate and view your model from every angle. It's nice, I can see there's a reflection of the environment in the lenses. In the brush library, we have now a new section called Materials, and I think some of these brushes are new and some are old. So let's pick a brush and color on the glasses. You color it just like you would do on canvas. In the layers you can see that our object was divided into separate parts, so you can color each part individually. Let's color now the frames. I'm going to take a different brush, maybe Syrup from Inking, and I can draw here. Let's see if I can turn on symmetry to have the same lines on the other side of the frame. No, unfortunately I don't see here that option. So we just have to draw it separately, or maybe we can copy the layer and then flip it horizontally. Anyways, there are more interesting settings you can use when painting in 3D. In the Actions menu, we have here now this 3D card. And here we can see what we drew in the 2D view. You can also draw on it. And here we can change the lighting and environment for our object. So these are the lights. You can move them around. And if you tap on it, you can change the intensity and color of the light. You can also add more lights if you want to. Another cool feature that was added is viewing the object in AR. So it will be placed in the place where you will point your iPad's camera. So now those glasses are on my desk. That's a very interesting way to present your 3D model. Let's go back to the brushes, and here if we want to change the settings of the brush, we have new options. The brushes that have materials applied to them are shown on this sphere. And here are the materials. You can adjust metallic and roughness of the brush. If you want to save your painted model, you can save it as a USDZ or OBJ file. And you can also make a little animation with the object, like this. When you're painting on a 3D model, this arrow tool looks a little bit different than what we are used to. You can transform your layer in a 3D way like this. And here I painted on my glasses a little bit more, and I forgot to show you that in the light and environment settings, you can change the environment to one of those options. So now as you can see, there is a different reflection in my glasses. That's kind of fun. So these are all the new features involving 3D models. But there will be more nice updates when it comes to a regular 2D drawing. Let me show you, and I must say that I am quite pleased with the new options that I saw. So I'm going to create a new canvas, and I'm going to pick any brush. Maybe let's check monoline. And I'm tapping on it again to open the brush settings. And here now we don't have streamline option like it was before. It was moved to stabilization section here. and there are some more ways to control the brush's behavior. When streamline was giving you smoother, less shaky lines, now you can also adjust the stabilization and achieve way more smooth lines. The lines are fixing themselves while you draw to look nice and smooth. If you make the stabilization too high, that effect might be too strong. So I think keeping that both streamline and stabilization in the middle will be optimal. But of course, it's all up to you and to your needs and liking. You can change those settings in every brush you want, or now you can also adjust the brush stabilization for the whole app. Just go to the Actions menu, Preferences, Pressure and Smoothing, and here you can change it and make your lines smoother. Another very nice and needed feature is the possibility to save the size of your brush. So if I'm going to draw something and I will be changing the brush size a few times, I can save up to 4 brush sizes and have them locked here. You just have to tap on this plus here, and now this size is added. Let's add another size. Draw something, and now if I want to go back to the size I used before, I can just tap on it here. You can do the same with the opacity. And if you want to take this size off, just tap on this minus sign here. The new Procreate update will also give you a new brush section with 8 of your recently used brushes. So it will be much easier to remember and go back to the brush you have used before. We also will have a new way the color palette can look. You can go to the palettes, and here you can choose to have your colors presented in cards like this. And each color has a name that you can change if you want to. Another very useful feature is Page Assist. You can find it in the Actions menu, Canvas, and turn it on here. Now you can add more pages and draw on them separately. This will be very useful if you want to create a book, for example, and you can view each page like this. Also, you can import the PDF file and see it in the pages this way. Okay, I'm going to merge these layers together and show you one more change in the app. Now, if we go to the adjustments, we would pick one adjustment and have here an option to choose to do it on the whole layer or using a pencil. Now, those options are not here, they were moved, and we automatically are going to add the adjustments to the whole layer. You can change the settings here like before. And now, at the top, we can pick layer or pencil. If I'm going to pick the pencil, I can just add the adjustments only on the area I'm coloring now. And then again, I can change it to the layer and keep adjusting the settings if I want to. I think this is more convenient to use than it was before. The last thing I'm going to talk about here is a possibility of adding one finger touch gestures. So if you don't like to use two fingers to zoom in and zoom out like this, you can go to your iPad settings and find here Procreate. And now you can enable single touch gesture companion. When we go back to the Procreate, we will have this little tab here. We can move it around and we can pick here zoom. And now with only one finger, we can zoom in and zoom out. Personally, I think I will not be using it and I will stick to two fingers, just because I'm used to it. So these are most of the new features that will be coming with the update, and here are some more things you can expect. I am mostly looking forward to those brush updates. Let me know what you are excited the most about. Thank you for watching and see you in my next video. Bye!